How's it going, everyone, and welcome to the show. I'm your host, Mike Stark, and on today's video, we'll be going through my top 10 most extreme, over-the-top, disturbing horror films that I've ever seen. Now, let's get this video started with the first title being Eli Roth's 2013 masterpiece, The Green Inferno. Now, what can I say? This cover says it all. Just disgustingly brilliant. This film is about cannibalism, death, escape, and South America. And if you haven't seen this movie, it's about these kids from college that go to South America to protest in the rainforest when they bump into the natives there that are these just cannibals that live there in the rainforest, and they kill and eat the kids, and it's just, yeah, it's so crazy and messed up. But anyways, the next title is the 1974 controversial Tobe Hooper film based on the serial killer Ed Gein, and that is The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. What can I say? If you haven't seen this movie, it's about a chainsaw-wielding maniac that kills anyone that comes into his path in Texas. And yeah, it's about these kids that go off exploring in Texas, go into this abandoned house where they meet Leatherface, and then they're fighting for their lives after that, the additional kids that aren't killed. Anyways, the next title is the 2023 Brandon Cronenberg film, and that is the peculiar film, Infinity Pool. Now, if you haven't seen this movie, it's definitely not for everyone. It is really messed up, unusual. So it's Alexander Skarsgård, Mia Goth, Cleopatra Coleman, and this film, Brandon Cronenberg had big shoes to fill because his father, David Cronenberg, is also an unusual filmmaker too. But if you haven't seen this movie, it's about these two couples that meet on this island, this fictional island called Leotolka, and accidentally kill someone, and the penalty for death there, because they try to cover it up, is execution. But they buy their way out, they clone. The guy, Alexander Skarsgård, clones himself, and then this kid stabs him to death, and it's messed up. Anyways, the next title is the weirdly bizarre, gross, gory Japanese horror film by Takeshi Miike, and that is Audition. Now, a lot of people have seen this movie, but a lot of people haven't seen this movie as well. And this here is just, yeah, awesome Japanese horror cinema about this guy that's single, that wants to find love, puts this this audition tape out there for women to audition so he can fall in love with someone. And then he meets this crazy woman who tortures and just, yeah, is just sadistic and does all this crazy things. She's a psycho. She gets this wire and she cuts his, yeah, ligaments off, and it's just disgusting. Anyway, the next crazy film on this list is number 6, and that is Lars von Trier's Antichrist, starring William Dafoe and Charlotte Gainsbourg. Now, if you haven't seen this movie, yeah, very messed up, ultra, ultra sexual, high impact violence, and just, yeah, it's a film about this couple that go out to this cabin in the middle of nowhere. They retreat there because they're having troubles in their lives, and the woman there, William Dafoe's wife, wants to kill him. That she goes crazy, and if you haven't seen this movie, you're in for a treat, because William Dafoe gets his dick bashed in with a brick and he comes blood. It is so just, I'm not gonna speak about that film anymore. The next one is the 1989 Ryan Usner just disgusting horror film, and that is Society, about a bunch of aliens that participate in this group orgy, about this kid that lives in Beverly Hills, finds out his parents are not all they seem to be, and all practical effects. This film is definitely one of a kind that needs a 4K release. Disgusting. But anyways, the next one on the list is the 2008. This film is a staple in the horror community, and is a staple in just horror films in general, and that is Pascal Lugier's the original 2008 Martyrs. Now, this film is not only a great horror film, but it's a great film in general, and this film is a masterpiece. I really love this film. The remake does not compare to this. This is just takes gore to the extreme. Now, if you haven't seen this movie, it is so messed up. It opens up with this little girl running in the streets with their clothes all ripped, and then it flashes forward to the present day. But what it's about is about these kids that take revenge on their attackers that molested and raped them and tortured them as kids. And then they actually, while they're getting revenge on their attackers, the people that organize this all, the people higher up, come to the house, and then there, then the kids as adults are taken against their will again hostage to this basement and then tortured to the extreme. Skin flayed, just bashed, but it's just a beautifully, it's a beautiful, like, I know it sounds fucked up to say this, but it's a great, like, it's a beautiful movie, like, just, it's about survival, and, yeah, I don't know, I like it, anyways. Now, the next two films, the next two films fall into the place of number three, because I wanted to put these as one film, but because they're in the same franchise, and because I kind of consider them to be one film because it's a part two is a continuation of part one, and this is the Clive Barker's The Hellraiser movies. Clive Barker's masterpiece here. Extremely gory, just not for the faint of heart. These two films, I've spoken about them in my previous videos, definitely gross, gory, over the top, extreme horror. Doesn't get more extreme than these two movies here. Part two is more extreme than part one, I would say, just by a bit. But if you haven't seen these movies, Hellraiser 1 is about this puzzle box and these demons come out of it, and anyone that comes into contact with the demons, they get tortured and killed. It's got to do with deception, sex, just, yeah, this film is definitely, yeah, R18 doesn't really give it justice, because when this came out, it got an X rating and they had to turn it down. But the sequel is even worse than the first one. It's all set in hell. Continuation of part one, set in a mental asylum. This is just, yeah, it's so, I can't really even explain it. I'm not gonna even go there. It's just, if you've seen it, it's surreal. It takes horror to a whole new aspect of horror. Anyways, number two, the runner up here on this list is a great Eli Roth film, and this is what slingshotted him into ultra stardom, made him super famous, and that is Hostel 1 and 2. I put part 1 and 2 in the second place because, again, part 2 is a continuation of part 1. This film here, part 1 is about these rich people that rich people pay to torture and kill kids in Eastern Europe, and the people that are running this hostel, it's all staged, and yeah, they get drugged, taken against their will to this this factory, this warehouse, where there are these rooms, and then yeah, from there, these rich people that pay these even richer people that run this thing to, yeah, torture and kill these kids. Part two, continuation of part one. But yeah, what can I say? Messed up and just, yeah, definitely, just check it out. I'm not gonna continue about that, but anyways. Now, the last one on the list is one that you probably all know what it is without me having to tell it to you all, and this is the 2009 just grotesquely disgusting and abhorrent horror film set in Germany, and that is Human Centipede number one. Now, number two is pretty bad, but number one is what I think to be the most messed up extreme horror movie that you'll probably ever see. And if you haven't seen this movie, you're definitely in for a treat, because this film is just fucked up. What the film's about, these two girls in Germany, I think it's Germany or Austria, can't remember, but their car breaks down in the middle of the night. It's raining, they knock on this door in the middle of nowhere, this doctor opens it up, he drugs them, and then performs all these medical procedures on these two girls and a victim that he took prior to that. You don't see the victim get taken, but he's this Japanese guy. And the two girls get, one of the girls gets her mouth sewn onto the other girl's asshole, and then the girl in front of her gets her mouth sewn onto the Japanese guy's asshole. and then he shits into her mouth, and yeah, it's just so messed up. 100% medically accurate, 100% medically inaccurate, and 100% politically inaccurate. But what can I say? This cover says it all. But anyways, what can I say? This video is done! So if you've liked this video, give it a thumbs up, comment down below with your thoughts on this video, but also what you think is the most messed up horror film that you've ever seen. And also, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do yourself a favor and subscribe, because this is the best channel on YouTube for physical media and movie-related content. But also, if you have subscribed to this channel, thank you all for supporting me. Love yous all. We're a big family here, but stay tuned, because I upload regularly here on this channel. I try to do 2 reviews and unboxings in a week, and I try to throw in a top 10 video here and there. But anyways, I'm out of here, everyone. So I'll catch you all in my next video. But until then, have a good night. Thank you.